Jupiter doesn't orbit the sun. And no, that is not clickbait. It is very much reality. So I'm going to demonstrate what exactly that means using Universe Sandbox here. So this is the solar system, and we got all the planets here, and of course you'll notice that Jupiter is orbiting around the center of the solar system just like the other planets. But Jupiter, unlike the other planets, they are all orbiting the sun. Jupiter is not actually orbiting the sun. Just about everything else is. In fact, I'm pretty sure everything else is orbiting the sun. But not Jupiter. So let me show you what's going on. So if I create a new empty simulation, okay, I'm going to now add just the sun and Jupiter, just to keep it simple so we can see what's actually happening here. So I'm going to add the sun. Although, because of the situation of the way that the sun and Jupiter interact, in order to get Universe Sandbox to actually show that properly, you have to do binary and balance motion on. Because otherwise it'll kind of pick one to be the main body and it'll show the motion weirdly. So I'm gonna put down the sun, and then I want to go and find Jupiter. Now, Jupiter is about a little over five AU on average from the sun. So I'm just gonna plop it about 5.2 is what I'm gonna go for. Just like that. Okay. So we have the sun and we have Jupiter. The simulation is pretty slow here, so I'm gonna speed this up. Speed this up a lot so we can actually see what's happening. That might be enough. Okay. So you got Jupiter going around the sun here. Now, if we zoom in on the sun, you'll notice it has a trail. So Jupiter has a trail, so the trail is just showing the orbit. Like, it's not like it, Jupiter doesn't actually have a trail, it's just Universe Sandbox shows a trail to show the path that an object is following. So if we zoom in on the sun here, you'll notice the sun isn't just stationary, it's not just sitting in the middle of the system while Jupiter goes around it. The sun is actually doing its own little orbit. Okay? And that's because Jupiter is large enough and far enough that the barycentre, the common point between the sun and the Jupiter in terms of gravitational influence, is actually not within the sun. It's actually slightly outside of the sun. All the other planets, that point is within the sun. So it's accurate to say that all the other planets do orbit the sun. But with Jupiter, it's slightly outside. And you'll notice, if I put my cursor, try to put it in the middle of this circle here. This might take a couple rotations for me to get it right. Yeah, it's not quite right. Once I find the middle of the circle, you will notice that if you look at the point on the cursor, the sun will never actually touch it. And that point is what both the sun and Jupiter are orbiting. So Jupiter is actually orbiting around empty space, slightly outside of the sun. It doesn't actually orbit the sun itself. The sun is not the center of Jupiter's orbit. So I think that's pretty cool. Technically all planets cause this sort of motion in the sun. It's just that most of the planets are too small to have the barycentre outside of the sun. Most are within the sun. So the Earth, for instance, is way too small for this to happen. But it does happen all within the sun, and basically what that looks like is the sun just has a little bit of a wobble. And that's actually one of the main ways that we look for exoplanets, is looking for that little wobble in the star. And that's why it's so much easier to find large exoplanets, because the stars have these huge wobbles. And just to kind of exaggerate things, just so that you can get a really good idea of what's going on here. I'm going to increase the mass of Jupiter, but that might actually break this, but let's see what happens. If I double the mass of Jupiter, will that actually... Okay, the sun... Okay. No, that might have broke it. Let's just speed this way up. Yeah. Okay. So it got this this sort of like corkscrew motion, and that's caused by the sun already having some velocity, because, you know, the system was kind of already in motion when we did that. So what I'm curious, if I create a new simulation, well, actually, without even using Jupiter, I could even just do something different, just so you can kind of get what's actually happening. If I put, say, just for the sake of showing what's happening, say I put the Earth and I put Mars. Mars is not super smaller. Compared to the Sun and Jupiter, Earth and Mars are basically the same size. But they are different in size, so this should create kind of an exaggerated version of what we see with the Sun and Jupiter. So Mars is, you know, Jupiter in this scenario. And then the Earth, you'll see, is getting its little tail. So if I speed this way up, see what happens. So you see that? The Earth has a very noticeable orbit around that invisible point in space, and that's also the same point that Mars is orbiting. And you'll notice that they're always opposite in their orbits to each other, and it's the same thing with the Sun and Jupiter. So yeah, so that's what happens when you have two bodies that are close enough in mass and the right distance apart. They don't actually... One isn't actually orbiting the other. They actually kind of orbit each other, which results in them both kind of orbiting an empty point in space. But you can very clearly see here that the Mars's orbit in this scenario is not going around the Earth. It's going around the center here, which is nothing. And it's the same thing with Jupiter. pretty crazy stuff. And it's the same thing too with we could look at, say, binary stars. So Alpha Centauri A and B, for instance, they orbit E. They have a similar thing going on there. I'm curious actually if they have a simulation for that. I'm not actually sure. I haven't looked for it before. Probably should have. It would have been good for this video, but I think the Earth and Mars thing gets the point across pretty well. Supermassive black hole binary. Okay, that's interesting. Let's look at this. Okay, this even mentions the barycentre. The black holes at their centers. Okay, yeah. So this is what happens when you have two objects that are very close in mass. You get this sort of Venn diagram sort of shape. And they're elliptical orbits, so everything that I've shown so far is everything kind of has perfectly circular orbits. But of course the shape of the orbit and the relative masses of the objects and everything are going to change what exactly is going on there. But the point is, these two black holes, just like Jupiter and the Sun, orbit an empty point in space. It's pretty interesting. But yeah, I think that is pretty much it. I think that gets, hopefully, that makes things pretty clear. Because it is kind of a weird thing to kind of wrap your head around. Jupiter doesn't actually orbit the Sun, and that's a fact. So anyway, like, subscribe, hit the bell if you'd like to see more stuff like this, and thanks for watching.